side, when we hear the word, our eyes glaze over. Our minds begin to focus on sweating, sore muscles, and our lungs trying to escape from our bodies via our mouths. We all may not have the same idea of exercise. My idea of pumping iron is lifting a fork to my mouth. I have mastered the tortilla chip biceps curls. When I go for the burn, that means I'm getting my chips and hot sauce. Our idea and attitudes about exercise prevents us from being all we can be. We need to change our idea of exercise if we want to reduce our health risks. Aerobic cardiovascular training and strength training are two ways to reduce those risks. When we incorporate them into our lives, we receive numerous benefits. How can we change our negative ideas about exercise? Well, let's find out how. We need to exercise our heart just like we need to exercise any other muscle in our body. When we exercise our heart, it increases the oxygen in our blood. According to IDEA, the Health and Fitness Source website, in the article How to Make a Habit and Change Your Life, on June 27, 1999, quote, aerobic cardiovascular fitness is achieved when you maintain a heart rate of 65 to 85% of your maximum heart rate for 20 minutes or more, unquote. We can do any physical activity that we enjoy to do, as long as we increase our heart rate. Some of us have the idea if we go out every couple of weeks and engage in a strenuous activity, that's a good aerobic cardiovascular workout. It's not. Our body's going to pay us back with stiff muscles, and maybe our heart is going to land us in the emergency room with the doctor standing over us going, paddles and clear, as thousands of volts of electricity try to knock our heart back into rhythm. Electric shock is not a good way to exercise our hearts. To determine what our maximum heart rate is, we can take personal wellness class during the MCC or stop even from Marshall Town Hawaii. All we need to remember for now is we need to spend 20 to 30 minutes at least 3 times a week, and our mind and body will reach toward us. Our minds will begin to say, hey, that was fun. I think I want to do that again. And our body will reward us by having our metabolism be increased for at least 2 hours after we're done working out. If you think working out for 20 minutes and burning a higher amount of calories for 2 hours is great, wait until you hear about strength training. Strength training does not necessarily mean pumping iron. According to IDEA, the Health and Fitness Source website, in the article How to Make a Habit and Change Your Life, on June 27, 1999, quote, strength training is when you apply force or resistance to a muscle. Resistance can be gravity, bands, machines, or our own bodies in isometrics. There are a few myths associated with strength training. One is, after I stopped working out, all my muscle turned to fat. Muscle cannot turn to fat. It's like thinking your eyeball can turn into a kneecap. It changes. Fat cells grow and shrink, and muscles lengthen and strengthen. Excuse me. Ladies, we do not have to worry about looking like the East German women in the 76 Olympics. For those of us who aren't born yet, these women look like men. They had facial hair, had bulging muscles, and they were on steroids. We can't make bulging muscles like men. And if we're still afraid of bulking up, all we have to remember is to lift lighter weights quickly with a high number of repetitions. Men, on the other hand, have all the natural testosterone to make those nice bulging muscles. They need to remember to lift heavy weights slowly with fewer repetitions. And again, we just need to work out 20 to 30 minutes at least 3 times a week. And to find out more about strength training, we can take a personal wellness class here at MCC or start with a Marshall Town Y. The best reason for strengthening and lengthening our muscles is it takes 50 to 60 calories to maintain 1 pound of muscle. On the other hand, it only takes 3 calories to maintain 1 pound of fat. According to Kelly Goss, aerobics coordinator at the YWCA, article, Are You Muscle Phobic? She also states that you burn a higher amount of calories for at least 6 hours after you get done with your strength training workout. If you think that's the only benefit from exercise, wait till you hear this. benefits that were found in the 1996 study to the American Journal of Health Promotion in an article, Make Fitness Happen, on Idea of Health Fitness Source website. Quote, physical fitness reduces the risk of dying from heart disease, of developing high blood pressure. It reduces high blood pressure in those of us who have it. It reduces the risk of colon cancer. It controls weight. It reduces the anxiety and feelings of anxiety and depression. And it builds healthy bones, unquote. Lastly, I found on this site was the same information that Darcy gave us a few days ago. The average American spends 4 hours a day watching television. We have to agree that 30 minutes of physical fitness is going to give us more benefits than 30 minutes of TV. Our biggest obstacle is believing what we do today won't affect us tomorrow. It's not an immediate result, but over time, the differences will show. So what do you think now when you hear the word exercise? All we have to do is learn 30 minutes at least 3 times a week to work our cardiovascular system, and another 30 minutes at least 3 times a week to strengthen our muscle. In return, we'll feel good about exercise. We'll feel good because of all the benefits exercise gives us, and we want to live with those benefits. All we need to do is change our idea of exercise, which is 30 minutes, and we reduce many risks and achieve many benefits. What will we think when and do when we hear the word exercise now? Our eyes will open wide and our minds will think, yeah, let's go for the burn.